because the word of God says, you know, when you build a house, some people call it Mason Cottage, some can call it James Cottage, some can call it Harmony Cottage. I believe you are receiving that as your own counselor. I believe you are receiving that as your own counselor. God said he will give us 3 jobs this year. How many of us remember that prophecy? Give us 3 jobs this year. One has landed already. I don't know whether you are the next online. You need a new job, is coming your way this morning. Hallelujah. Now you can call your house anything you want to call it. But when God wanted to name his own house, he said, my house shall be called a house of prayers. House of prayers. So we're going to pray 3 prayers before we go into our thanksgiving this morning. Is that all right? Amen. Let's rise to our feet. Quickly. We do that quickly. 2:30 a.m. two days ago, I had the voice of the Spirit of God. He said, I did not create life to be ups and downs. I created life to be up and up. I did not create life to be up and down. I created life to be up and up. And I saw that in Psalm 84 verse 7, when the word of God says, and they move from strength to strength, every one of them in Zion appearing before God. From strength to another one, to another one, to another one. This morning, let's say, Father.
Father.
Let's say, Father.
Father.
I can't hear you. Father.
Father.
From today.
From today.
My life.
Is no longer.
Up and down.
Up and down.
But up and up. Let's open our mouth and begin to pray. Father, Lord, from today, according to your word, you said you have not created. Again, but whoever drinks of the water I will give to him will never thirst again. The water I will give him will become a well of water springing up to eternal life. And I heard the voice of the Almighty God. He said, the dry season is over.
Yeah.
The dry season is over.
Yeah.
All right, can you please preach to the person next to you and say, the dry season is over? I say your dry season is over. I stand in the position that he has put me when he called me on the 2nd of July. I say your dry season is over. I say your dry season is over. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Now, thirdly, quickly, can I have your attention, everyone? I ask them to bring this here. Can everyone have a good view of this? What comes to our mind when we look at this? Quickly, this is a ludo. How many of us have heard that game? That is the green house, the red house, the blue house, and the yellow house. Yeah? And then you travel this way, all the way down there. How many of us have heard this game? And then you come back here and they say you are the one who has won. Praise the Lord. Without praying, without doing anything, God brought me a ludo. He brought me a ludo. I can't remember the last time I saw it. He brought me a ludo. And he began to explain to me. He said, there is embargo on people's lives. He said, from today, the embargo is lifted.
Yeah.
I didn't understand that. He said, when you get, you play with dice. You understand dice. You throw the dice, you come out here, yeah? And you travel all the way down there and come back. He said, but if this man here comes and hides behind you, yeah? He hides behind you here. You come out here, once you get here, he pushes you back in. Praise the Lord. And then the embargo is there. Praise the Lord. Now the Lord said we should pray this morning that every satanic embargo that has pushed me back inside, From today, by the Holy Spirit, you are lifted. The word of God says, and Jericho was straightly shut up. He said, nobody could come out and nobody could go in. Joshua chapter 6, verse 1. Jericho was straightly shut up. Nobody could go out, nobody could go in. A siege was laid on Jericho. If that prayer comes here, there's a siege on this man here. Once he gets out, before he travels so far, he's killed and he comes back home. We're going to pray. Anti-job embargoes. Anti-career embargoes. Fall down and die. And he's straightly shut up and he's looking for another seat before he comes out, if you understand that game. We're going to pray. Anti-finance embargo. Operating in my life. You are a liar. You are a liar. You are a liar. Catch fire. Having challenges with your deadlines, having challenges with the examination, and you are being asked to come and spend another year, or whatever it is an embargo. Academic embargo today is ended in Jesus. Yeah. I said academic embargo today is ended in the name of God. And I said, Father, academic embargo. Name we have prayed. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.